a common question. I know how to do track changes in Word, how to do it in Excel. That button which was there is gone. What do I do? Here is the answer. The old method of track changes is still there, but Microsoft removed that button not to trouble you because they have given you a better method. So what do? Nothing. You just store Excel file on OneDrive or Teams or SharePoint. That's all. Once the file is on one of these three, share it with people. They will edit it. There is no copy paste. One copy of the file. They can edit it online or offline on any device. You can do the same. In fact, you can edit the same file at the same time. All that doesn't matter. Now, every change made by every person is being logged. Now, where do you see the log? That's the only question. Now, if you want to be very sure that it will work, go to the browser version of Excel. Open the file, right-click on any cell which you know you have changed or someone else has changed, and there is an option, Show Changes. It opens a separate pane and it will show you if there are any changes. But now, are you going to see it cell by cell? No. Excel is crowded, so much data in it. No problem. There's a drop-down on top. You can go to a sheet and see it, or you can select a range and look at it at range level as well. It will show you changes to formulas as well as values. And if there are multiple changes made to the same cell, it'll show you that as well. All this is great on browser. The same feature is available on desktop as well. But for that, you need the Office 365 version of Excel. That's all there is to it. If there are multiple changes in a given context, for example, for a sheet, it will give you see changes and then it'll expand to show all changes. So problem solved, right? No, not solved. Life is not that simple. Excel is not that simple. Business is not that simple. Because you're going to send a file to some people as attachment. Now all that benefit is not going to come. Your file different, someone changed and sent it back. Now how do you compare? People do all kinds of jugglery, formulas, macros to do this without realizing for years, I think 10 years now, Excel already has an amazing feature to manage this. That feature is called Inquire. I'll create a separate video for it. But right now, let's focus on how to get that Inquire tab. Do you have that menu? No? Then go to File, Options, Add-ins, Com Add-ins, Go, and finally you will see the Inquire checkbox. Click OK. Done. If you still don't see Inquire, that means you have a standard version of Excel, not Pro version. Now, what do you do in that Inquire? Keep both the files open first, My File and Revise File, Original Revise, whatever. Now go to Inquire tab and just click on one button, Compare Files. That's it. It will do the job and it'll give you this brilliant output. One side, one file, another side, another file, all the changes listed, and those changes are categorized. Formatting changes separate, formula changes separate, value changes, structure. Oh man, first time people see it, it's almost orgasmic, you know. So try it out. And then you will never have to write a single formula to compare files. And as though this is not enough, and auditors will love this, the comparison itself can be exported as an Excel sheet, which becomes evidence, and you can use it later. And that is how, without track changes also, you can track changes. Now let's go back to the old one. That old one works only when the file is on a file share. It does not work when you put the file on OneDrive or SharePoint or Teams. Earlier, old days, we had file servers and file shares. And even people used to create a folder on local machine, share it with others. Because internet was not good, networking was closed, whatever. Never mind. So this track changes is designed for that era. So what do? First of all, you have to find the button called track changes. Microsoft has removed it from the menu. It's still there. So go to Excel, right click on ribbon, and now say customize. Customize what? That mini toolbar, quick access toolbar. I hope you know that. I just created a very nice video about quick access toolbar. Have a look. Right click on the ribbon, customize quick access toolbar. Now we have to find the track changes button. Sure. Open this drop down, go to all commands. Takes time because there are thousands of commands. Many of them have never seen the light of the day because there was no space in the menu. Now search for track changes and add it. There's another related command called share workbook. Add that as well. Click OK. Now you will see these two commands in the quick access toolbar. Now click on track changes and say highlight changes. It'll say OK, this will share the workbook. OK, done. Now you can share this on a file share. Give permission to other people. Now multiple people can edit that file. But what happens to changes? Let me show you. So look at this number. This is 23 right now. I'm going to change it to 40. A blue border comes. Oh, that's how I know it has changed. What has changed? Take the mouse cursor there. It shows you before, after. So 23 changed to 40. Now I'm going to change it again to 50. Now what should it show? So it shows the change one at a time. Now if I save and then reopen, it is going to remember the final change at the time of save. Intermediate changes of no value anyway. Very good. Now what happens? I inserted a row. That is also shown. I deleted a row or column. That is also shown. I added a sheet. All kinds of changes are shown. Very good. When I want to get a list of changes, I click on the highlight changes button again. And now you say list changes on another sheet. And see how beautifully it is giving you sort of an audit trail. Now, how long does this last? In the web version, which I told you about the earlier one, 60 days, here you can change the number. So you go to share workbook and you have all kinds of settings there to decide how long you want to keep the history and how you want to manage the show. So if there is a genuine need to do this, you can use this method. The limitation of this is, yes, you can put the file on OneDrive, but web-based editing will not work. Co-authoring, where multiple people edit the same Excel file using OneDrive, will not work. So I've given you three methods. Choose the one which is relevant to you in a given scenario. So you know what to do. Like, share, subscribe, bell icon. You're tired of listening to that, doing that also. There's a new thanks button. Explore that as well. But wait, before you go, I created a nice video about how to just navigate from place A to place B quickly and efficiently in Excel. Have a look at that. That's it for now. Thank you.